Does it make sense to you what I talk? But there's no equation, right? So next time when people ask, why do you need to know about flow pattern?
I wish you can talk, give him a talk, okay? So they appreciate this side of petroleum engineering. It's not just about reservoir. If we have a lot of oil that we cannot produce, what's the matter? It doesn't work, right? If we don't know how big should be the pipe size, maybe we say it's not economically feasible to do the production. It could be like that. So it is important. Next one, number three, more calculation. So we go through basic single phase flow, maybe not quite basic, and there's a heat transfer calculation for single phase flow, and we do pseudo single phase approach, right? Mix them together and do calculation, pressure drop approach. And I will show you that when there's a heat loss, kinetic term and elevation term is not going to do much, maybe 3%, 5%. Okay? So next we will do actual two-phase flow. Alright, first we need to know the definition. Okay? Liquid volume fraction. What is liquid volume fraction? So liquid volume fraction means by volume how much occupied by liquid, and that is liquid hole up. Okay? So average liquid hole up depends on how much is a gas liquid two-phase flowing pipe, how much is the flow of each phase. We need to get it. One method, okay? If you have very good sensor, okay? We say freeze, everything freeze, we cut the pipe, everything still freeze, and we count how much area occupied by liquid, how much occupied by gas. But we cannot do that, right? I wish we can do this. So it has this bubble flow, some bubble inside. Somehow I put liquid nitrogen in, everything freeze, frozen. I cut it like this. I see from the side and from the side, some part is, I cut the gas bubble and I count, hey, this is the area occupied by gas, this area occupied by gas. So the red area occupied by gas over the pipe cross-section area, I call that alpha, Y fraction. The rest that occupied by liquid, that is what? Liquid hole up. If we cannot do that, we do this. We have a quick closing valve, flow it in the pipe, trap both sides. Close it quickly, and whatever volume inside, divided by total volume, that's the liquid hole up. So I have flow in the pipe, I trap here, close the valve there, liquid fall. So if it is like this, we have about 50%. So liquid volume divided by total volume capacity of the pipe is liquid hole up in the lab. So we have to do it several times, then we get average liquid hole up, okay? Liquid hole up at an instance of time and at a particular link from the inlet, we can write it like this. HL equal to AL divided by AP. HL is a liquid volume fraction divided by total cross-section area. Okay. AL, area occupied by liquid over area occupied by, total area of the pipe, pi d squared over 4. Okay, now let's talk about superficial velocity. Superficial velocity is volumetric flow rate divided by a pipe. Okay. QL is liquid flow rate, AP is pipe cross-section area. This gives me velocity as if liquid is the only phase flowing the pipe. So we have QL, liquid flow rate, divided by total pipe area. So that's superficial liquid velocity. Superficial gas velocity is a gas flow rate divided by pipe area. So velocity as if gas is the only phase that flows in the pipe. Okay. If you want to calculate actual velocity instead of AP, we have to change to AG. Gas volumetric flow rate divided by cross-section area that occupied by gas will be actual gas velocity in the pipe. And that volumetric flow rate has to be in situ condition, not standard condition, okay? okay, I put here for constant velocity for a cube and then steel roll in a straight pipe, the superficial velocity is the same everywhere. Is that true? True under one assumption. I said VSL is the same everywhere. VSG is the same everywhere. Is that going to be true?
VS what?
VSL is constant. VSG is constant anywhere in the pipe.
They are the same?
Any location in the pipe, we have this condition. Is that true?
The flow
Phase flow is true under the assumption is the pipe is straight. There's no increase of AP or decrease of AP. And it's true under the assumption that it is kind of on average. Time average. Okay, time average. Any location, if I watch this location long enough, on average, with respect to time, I get one value of VSL. Another location, I will get the same VSL. Because sometimes, when you see like slug flow, sometimes there's a lot of liquid come, sometimes there's a lot of gas. Of course, at that location, at a particular time, we have more volumetric flow of liquid more than gas. And when we have gas come, we have more gas than liquid, right? So, this is on average, time average, not space average, time average. VSL is the same everywhere. If it is not the same, so I have high VSL here, less VSL here. We have accumulation. It come in a lot, but it go out a little bit, so it's accumulate. Pipe break. Okay. If I come in slow, but come out fast, I create vacuum, so it implode. Those things should not happen, right? And we assume whatever we do in this book is incompressible flow. We say that we are far well below sonic velocity. Okay? What's that sonic velocity? Square root something? RT? Square root RT or something, 331 or something meter per second for speed of sound in gas. What is the speed of sound in gas? 300 meter per second, is that what it is? Or more? 200
kilometer.
Kilometer or meter?
Kilometer per hour.
Oh, kilometer per hour? I think I should Google it, but okay, let's not do that, but I think it's about 300 something, it's very fast. Speed up sound. So by the time the slug flow, when I talk, you hear it right away at the speed of sound. But slug doesn't go reach you yet. It takes some time. Right? So we are far slower, a lot slower than speed up sound. So we say this is incompressible flow. Density doesn't change, even density of gas. So when we have entrainment, gas bubble go inside the liquid phase. Why don't we have the compression of gas? Gas become pressurized and volume shrink and it have more pressure. That doesn't happen in our case. So we assume constant density, a lot slower than speed of sound. And this is true in most cases in oil industry, except what? We are far below speed of sound in most cases for flow in the pipe. But in the production, at which location that we are not below speed of sound?
Choke.
When there's a restriction, there's a choke. We may be close to, or maybe at, maybe it could be more than speed of sound. Okay? All right, let's take a look at concept of liquid hold up. I'll show you two picture. Input four block or 4 cubic meter per second, and there's another 4 cubic meter per second for liquid. Conveyor belt the top one move at 4 meters per second. So this means I put this thing in, I wait 1 second, so I put 4 blocks in, right? Because my flow rate coming in as 4 cubic meters per second. So first second, I put 4 cubic meters in, wait 1 second, I put another 4 cubic meters in, wait 1 second, I put 4 cubic meters in, like that, okay? Just the analogy. And the speed of the belt moves for 4 meters per second too. So when I put this in here, right here, wait 1 second, the box is over there, the box is over there, the box is over there, okay? The top picture is for the case where 4 cubic meters per second and VL is 4 meters per second, or the belt velocity. Look at the bottom one. The input is the same, but the belt moves faster. Instead of 4, I put 6. So when I take a picture, which one that remain on the belt more? Top one, right? So when I move slower, it remains in the system more. When I move fast, it remains in the system less. Make sense? So this means, if I have the same volumetric flow rate, okay, coming in, but the actual speed in the pipe is a lot. So this means to maintain the same mass flow rate everywhere, it has to occupy small space. Let's take a look at this picture. Okay, and we'll go back to that. Input, I have top part is gas, bottom part is liquid. Okay. If there's no slip, everything move at the same speed. Inlet and actual condition or in situ condition is the same. There's no slip. But if I have gas move faster, at inlet, gas occupy a lot of space, but in situ condition, gas should occupy less space, right? Because whenever I move faster, it remains less in the system in order to maintain m dot or mass flow rate. Make sense to you? Let's go back to this, the conveyor belt analogy. Good question, huh? No question? Okay, let's see the math. Okay, here's just a definition that we should be very comfortable with. Superficial velocity, we use SI, meter per second, is volumetric flow rate divided by area of the pipe. VSG is gas volumetric flow rate, or QG, divided by area of the pipe. Mixture velocity, add VSI and VSG together, or is equal to total volumetric flow rate divided by total pipe cross-section area. Okay, that's mixture velocity. Liquid hold up is space time average. Okay, look at the first part. This part is space thing, right? HL RDR d theta is HL d area. Okay, so basically I integrate HL dA divided by A, okay, and integrate this with respect to time and divided by time. Good? This is to just do the average. Add things together and divide it by the weight. RDR d theta, and then you get from 0 to R and 0 to 2 pi. Okay, this is HDA and I divide it by pi r square. Yash, where's that R come from? Do you have this in the book, by the way? Which page that has this equation? Tell me, open it. Did you read a book or you just buy it and put it under the bed? Under the pillow or something?
Just bought it.
Page what? Am I going to find it first? Or I just make it up and it never exists?
That's not exactly what it is.
Page 3. So whoever claimed that he or she or he read a book, but don't answer this, I don't quite trust you. You see page 3, right? Look at this page 3. The formula is not the same as mine, but it means the same thing. Yash, where does that arm come from? Or who do you want to help you? Just point your finger, and he'll like you a lot. Victor, where does that arm come from?
Coordinate system,
you agree with that? So you know it, right? Huh? Where's that arm come from? Coordinate system? You have never seen this kind of thing before.
Yeah, I've seen that.
You seen it? Where's that come from? Coordinate system.
Yeah.
Can you derive it?
I can.
Okay. You may try. Isaac, where's that arm come from?
That's the radio
coordinate. Radio coordinate? Okay, of course.
So it's multiple coordinates.
No need to derive it from me. So to go quick, you need to know this. Okay. If you don't know, you should know it now. So when we do the integration for area, dA, we integrate dA in the cylindrical coordinate system, we get A. And this dA is, we have the radius, and I sweep it a little bit by d theta. So that angle is d theta. Okay, d theta. I extend a little bit over here. That is dr. Okay, and what about this length? I mean this length. So this part, I assume that it's kind of square. So this length is dr. And this length is what? R d theta, right? So theta is the curved part divided by the area, the radius. So that is theta. Curve part divided by radius equal to theta. So theta multiplied by radius, that equal to curve part. Or that length. That length is r d theta. And this part is dr. Together it become dA area. So dA over here is r d theta. Okay? And we integrate from whole trip. 0 to 2 pi. And 0 to r. Okay, for r we do 0 to r, capital R. And theta we do 0 to 2 pi. And that r pop up because we have to do r d theta multiplied by dr. Got it? If not, Google a little bit more. But okay, that's where it comes from. And we integrate it. So we h d a, we have to divide it by a. Because we average it, okay? And this we integrate with time and we divide it by delta t. All right, how big should be delta t? Enough until we have a stable value. So if my delta t is small and we have big h, something like this, but if it's long enough, it will be constant, okay? And that probably 10 seconds, 5 seconds, depending on what kind of flow and what are we doing for. If we want average liquid flow of slug, then we have to wait long enough. But if we want the average of film part liquid flow up, we don't wait, maybe half a second or something. Okay? What about this? That parenthesis, what does it mean? Multiply or what? HL parenthesis R theta T. Isaac, is that multiplication? Yes or no? Does it mean that H multiplied by those things? Yes. Hung?
No.
No? Hey, Hung say no. Why do you say yes? I said, you want to change your answer? What is in those parentheses thing? Function. This thing we say, H is a function of R, theta, and T. So this is, HL is a point value. It's not average. No, it's at a certain point, at a certain R, and there's a certain theta, and a certain time at that point. So that H value is like black and white, 0 or 1. Okay, that because you see point wise, okay, any point in space is just 0 or 1, but when you add them together, so integrate means you add them at black point, every black dot in the cross section area, and divided by cross section area, then we say, hey, it's not black, it's not white, it's gray. See what I'm saying? So when you average it, you will get something between 0 and 1. But that point value is just either 0 or 1, either half liquid or no liquid. Got it? But on average, this HL value or liquid hold up is between 0 and 1. 0 means no liquid, 1 means no gas. Okay? Gas one fraction is 1 minus hold up, no slip. Okay? No slip, we use the symbol lambda. Lambda L is QL over total Q. So we say, hey, liquid hold up is the same as volume fraction. If we say something like this, this means each phase travel at the same speed. Okay? No slip. Actual velocity of gas equal to actual velocity of liquid. Then we have this thing happen. Lambda L equal to HL for the case of dispersed flow. Okay? Single phase flow, pseudo single phase flow, emulsion flow, we have lambda I equal to H now. And it's also equal to VSL or VSL plus VSG. Okay? Just a math based on the top one. Slip velocity, slip mean VG minus VL. VG is not the same as VSG. Okay? What's the relationship between VG and VSG? Isaac?
What's the relationship
between VG?
That's the actual velocity.
Equal to VSG or not?
It's not.
Which one is more?
The
VSG. VSG is typically more or VG is typically more?
Oh, VSG is more.
VSG is more. Wrong. Any answer? You want to change your answer? I said it's wrong. Say it's less. That is correct. Why do you say such thing? Oh, look at this. VG, you think VSG is more? Really? Oh, maybe you're right. Okay, let's do the math. VG equal to QG over AG. Right? That is VG. VSG equal to QG divided by AP. For the case of two-phase flow, where both gas and liquid exist, H is greater than 0 and less than 1. Okay, so this means AP is more than AG, right? AP is more than AG, so VSG is less than VG. Agree now? Okay. What is the relationship between VG and VSG? Hey, what if I do this? Let me erase all this. I think I need to show you. Oh, it's over here already. See this part? VL equal to VSL over HL. You see this? So VL equal to QL over AL. And if I multiply by AL or AP over AP, that is 1, right? QL over AL multiplied by AP over AP, and I group this term, AL over AP is HL, and this term is VSL. So this formula is correct. Similarly, Vg is Vsg over alpha. Okay? Or 1 minus HL. Good. Total mass flow rate in the book, try and use F, try and use W. Total W is WL plus WG. Okay. Slip velocity, Vg minus VL. For no slip condition, 0 equal to Vg minus VL. Vg, I told you that it is Vsg over 1 minus HL, right? Last page, correct? That is Vg, actual gas velocity. VL is Vsl over HL, correct? Okay, so because it's equal to 0, I can just put the equal sign over here, right? So that's what we have over here. Good? Okay, move this over there, move this over there, we get this equation. Okay. And for the gas of 0, I rearrange it. You see this HL, HL, I move this to the same side, I rearrange it, I get HL equal to VSL. Over Vst plus Vsl by rearranging this equation. So this means for no slip case, HL indeed equal to lambda L, mathematically the same. Good? Okay. For the case that we have slip, slip happen when do you have slip in stratified flow? No.
We have wave.
I just told you dispersed bubble flow. We don't have slip. Anything that pseudo single fresh approach work, we don't have slip. When it's separate, most likely it has slip. So when we have fully dispersed flow, no slip. For sure. Slack flow, there's a slip. Stratified flow, yes, of course, there's a slip. And most of the time, gas phase travel faster than liquid phase, especially for horizontal or upward horizontal, because gas has less viscosity. Gas is like 1.2 e minus 5 pascal second, right? But water is 1 e minus 3, 0.001 pascal second. So it's 100 times more. Liquid has 100 times more viscosity than gas, and it also has more density. When it's more viscous, it's more difficult to move, so it retains in the pipe. But for downward flow, gravity plays a big role. So gravity like a magnet, it's sucking. It's not sucking, but okay, it attracts liquid phase to move down quick. Gas tends to lift up, right? So for downward flow, it is likely or possible, maybe not likely, that liquid phase flow faster. See what I'm saying? So this part, Vg greater than Vl. So we go back to this equation. Vg greater than Vl, I say, okay, Vsg minus Vsl, Vsg over 1 minus Hl, minus Vsl over Hl, greater than 0. Good, it's just a math from this line. V slip equal to that. And for Vg greater than Vl, V slip is more than 0. Okay, so I have this equation. Manipulate it a little bit, rearrange it, I get that. Okay. Well, how do we do that? I just move this to another side. Very easy, right? I get this thing. And I multiply both sides by value greater than 0. So left side multiplied by HL and right side multiplied by 1 minus HL. So I get this. I rearrange it. I get HL greater than lambda. Does it make sense? intuitively hold up more than no sleep liquid hold up. For the case where gas travel faster, it is. When we have gas flow faster, whatever flows slower remain in the pipe. Liquid flows slower, like the belt analogy, right? Whatever flows slower is have many things stay on the belt. So whatever flows slower, we have a lot remain. In this case, liquid flows slower, so liquid remain a lot. So when we have sleep, if liquid flows slower, HL is greater than lambda L. Good? The opposite is also true. If you have liquid move faster than gas, then liquid hold up is less than no sleep liquid hold up. Because gas flows slower, so gas stay in the pipe, but liquid flow down very quick. Good? Agree? It's just a math, okay? But it's also agree with what we think intuitively too. Okay, two phase flow variable, drift velocity. Drift velocity is a phase velocity relative to a surface moving at the mixture velocity or center of volume. In this course, we don't really use much drift velocity, but you will use it later on if you do drift flux model. Okay. Liquid drift velocity is VL minus VM. Okay. Gas drift velocity is VG minus VM. Okay. So if you want to know drift velocity of gas phase, what do you do? If I can make VM equal to zero, and we capture VG flowing, then V drift will be equal to VG, right? How do that make that happen? It's a little bit difficult, but okay, I have pipe full of liquid. I close both sides, put gas phase in, gas bubble moving out. But overall, so I have flow in the pipe. This pipe is full of liquid, and I just put one bubble inside. So this bubble moving up, right? Overall is zero, so Vm is zero. So the speed of the gas is the same as the speed of the drift velocity for that case. Okay, more detail we will talk more when we talk about slug flow. Drift flux, okay, flux of phase through surface moving at the center of volume velocity, or HL multiplied by delta V. This is J sub L. J sub G is alpha multiplied by Vg minus Vm. Okay. What is the volume flux? Volume flux is volume per unit area per unit time, right? Volume per unit area per unit time becomes velocity. So velocity is volume flux. But this case is just for the case of liquid, so we have HL over there. Alright, let's talk a little bit about oil-water dispersed flow viscosity. In the lab, okay, dispersed flow viscosity depends on droplet size, interfacial tension, density and viscosity of oil and water. This graph shows me, okay, pressure gradient versus water volume fraction. 0 mean no water, 100 mean full water. So pressure gradient experimental data show something like this. Okay. Homogeneous model shows something else. Okay. Only oil, this line. So what do you get from this? Adding water in, pressure gradient can be lower than just single phase oil. So when we add water, pressure gradient become lower. What does that tell me? We don't quite have really emotion in this case. If you do have emotion, it's not going to be like this. Emotion thing, which is homogeneous, if you have emotion, it's homogeneous, right? If it is homogeneous on that way, our model, emotion model, viscosity, pressure gradient will be more than single phase flow whenever you add water. So that's emotion. What is the gap over there? Where does that come from? Flipping, right? From the continuous space, from oil continuous space, we can get oil to water continuous space. Changing out the continuous space. Instead of oil and water, maybe instead of water and oil, become oil and water. This is the case showing you that if it has emulsion or no emulsion, what happened? Or you can tell, do we have emulsion? So, experimental results suggest no emulsion. But other people experimental results, if it has emulsion, pressure will be more. Now look at this one. This one is a little bit difficult, but it says, okay, viscosity and percent brine in emulsion. When we add brine or salty water into emulsion, viscosity goes up, exponentially. Okay? So whether the viscosity goes up or not, it depends whether we have an emulsion or not. Next will be... Oh, I have 1 minute left. So next will be about calculation, a little bit of calculation. Okay, we have 3 more examples and we will do more homework. Okay, I let you go 1 second earlier. Okay, see you next time. Bye-bye. And if you need to leave me other class, please come see me. Make sure you do homework. Homework is graded upon the submission. If you submit it, if you did it, you get 2 points, whether it's correct or not. But if you don't do it, it's 0. 2 minutes 0 will have the penalty toward your grade. Actually 1, maybe you cannot get a certain grade already. I wish you understand why 2-phase flow is important, okay? And how it behaves in the actual case in the lab. Next Thursday.
Next Tuesday or Thursday? Oh, for the lab?
For the lab. Next, it is next Thursday. The lab is 13 is the lab. 13 is next Thursday. Next Thursday we come in this room first. We do lecture and like last 10 minutes we go to the lab. It's not that long. We just show you something. Okay?
Last
1 minute. 10 minutes. Last 10 minutes. That brings it to class.